Okay, let me just see something here. Okay. I don't have this completely figured out, but I think when you were very, very young, a curtain did something to you. I'm gonna call it Yes, I Am a Bird Productions, because if you take all the letters and Joey Tribbiani and you rearrange them, that's what you get.
Wait. No, you don't. There's no S in your name, there's no D, there's no M.
That's your opinion, isn't it? Check this out. When someone calls the office, my development executive is going to answer the phone. Yes, I am a Bird Productions. Wah, wah, wah.
Wah, wah, wah? Why?
Because that's my catchphrase. I say it all the time. Anytime I walk in or out of a room.
You've never said that?
Yeah. You don't know
that. I've never heard that.
Really? Because I'm always thinking it.
Let's get to the movie theater. I hate missing previews.
All right, here we go. Wah, wah, wah.
Don't start now.
Where was that antique coffee table you wanted to show me?
Sorry, Michael, but if Joey ever saw this, I would die.
What? I just want to read the first part.
No, my chart is there. It's deleted forever. Come on, let's get lunch. I'm such a pain in the ass.
Well, it's deleted forever. Oh, how could I ever drag something out of the trash?
Oh, dimples. I miss the way it feels when you hold me.
No, no, Joey, you can't read that. It's very personal.
Touch me like no other man has ever touched me before. Wow. I gave you the benefit of the doubt, but I guess I owe your mom $50.
Oh, I didn't write it. Now, I mean it. Give it back. No, I mean it. Joey, don't read it. I'm telling you, don't read it. I'm asking you. Just come on.
Please tell me that
it's a candy bar.
Okay.
I so badly want to tell you that I still have feelings for you, but I know you've moved on. I probably should, too.
Who could this be about? She hasn't been with anyone since her husband, Eric, except for... Oh, my God. It is Eric.
Does that mean her diamond is fake? Oh, God, please let me have this. I never ask you for anything.
You always ask me for stuff.
Don't do that. You sound just like him.
Yeah, but aren't you dating Joey's assistant?
Look, Glenn's great, but there's no ring on this finger. Oh, that's hilarious. They think I'm flipping him off. Put it down. All right, I'll be back.
Stop staring at me. They didn't even ogle my mom when she walked away.
Well, they're probably gay.
Oh, yeah, they heard that.
I just don't know what to do. They're both so great, but so different. I mean, do I follow my heart or opt for security?
You've been gone 10 minutes! All right, let's just get this over with. Just do what you have to do.
Oh, we will.
What are you doing?
We never perform judo without stretching properly.
Bobby Morgan Stern's line.
Hi, this is Joey Tribbiani. Is Bobby there?
I'm sorry, no. All her calls have been forwarded to this line.
This might take a minute. She got a new assistant. Sounds awful.
It's me, Gina.
Oh, that's funny. My sister's name is Gina. Gina. All right, Gina, I know you're trying to hide it from me, but I think you're working for Bobby.
I got a huge audition tomorrow that I need to get so badly, Michael, that I can't even make the simplest decision. Like, I can't even decide whether I should sit or stand. I mean, if I sit, then they can focus on what I'm doing with my eyes, you know? But if I stand, well, then it frees me up to explore the space with my body. You know what I mean?
You should sit.
Yeah, you're right.
This is my nephew, Michael.
Hi. I'm Carmen.
Oh.
Your collar's a little up in the back.
Oh.
There you go.
Thanks. Please have sex with her.
Michael!
I'm sorry. Look, you have a big problem here.
Joey! I came down to watch your big scene.
Oh,
hey.
Oh.
Hey. Oh, and you.
Yeah.
Oh, gimme. Oh. Oh, what are you doing here?
He's here to stop me from jumping into bed with Carmen Electra.
Oh, really? Well, who's stopping him from jumping in bed with me?
I can't wait that long. All right, I'm gonna have to run for it. How far away are we?
Like 9 miles.
Okay, 9 miles in 45 minutes. Can I do that?
Are you a Kenyan man with a number on your back?
I don't know what that means. So you're telling me you're not a virgin anymore?
Not above the belt, I'm not.
I don't know what that means.
So look, I have another shot with her tonight, but here's the thing. Her cousin Marcy's in town, so I thought the four of us...
No. I'm not going on some double date. I got too much stuff going on. Just leave me out.
But Joey, come on. It's no big deal. I need you to be my sex partner.
Your what?
The guy who goes with you to the bar helps you get sex.
It's called a wingman.
Really?
Yeah.
It sounds kind of gay. You're my uncle. I shouldn't have to work this hard for you to be my sex partner.
Wingman! Nobody tells me I carry my bag weird. What? Table!
Are you crazy? Look at the table.
Michael, be quiet. Table!
Hey, nobody tables my son. His metaphor is apt.
No, you two are working this out.
Stop it!
Get her away!
No! Hey, okay, fine. Go in there. Here. You staying in there until you work this out. Now talk to each other.
Hey, you think you can keep us in here? We'll just go through the window.
Oh, sure. Go out the window, not the front door, you idiot.
Call me an idiot.
No, I'm talking to the other idiot in the room.
Every time Joey's name comes up, he gets all grumpy.
Oh, well, that's not right. This is a huge night for Joey. He flew him out here. It's just like my mom when I graduated from law school.
3 seconds.
What?
3 seconds before you made it about you.
If it makes you feel any better, I have a similar situation with my parents.
3 seconds!
This is so exciting. It's your big premiere.
It reminds me of the opening night for my 10th grade play. I played Maria in West Side Story. Oh my God, I just made it about me again. I'm sorry. Got a standing ovation.
This is the biggest, best thing I've ever done. He is gonna walk away impressed. Oh, wait till he sees my love scene. It's my best work since Vampire Lust 3. I was all... Oh, good, you're ready. Okay, let's go. But you know what? That's not my problem. You're the dad. You should be happy for me. That's your job! Obviously, this means nothing to you. Pretty impressive, huh? Now, if you'll excuse me, I don't have to take this. I have a date with Carmen Electra.
Really? Hey, did you see her new billboard?
Wrong thing to say again, red-haired guy. You know what? You suck in real life, too. I'm gonna do it. Okay. All right. Thanks, Gina. You're the best. The kid is back! Yeah. Oh, gotta do my warm-up. Acting exercises. This is an acting exercise.
How'd it go with Sarah?
Well, she's not mad at me. In fact, she doesn't mind if I see other women.
That's great.
Kind of. Yeah, she's actually with another guy right now.
You okay with that?
Not really. Feeling a little jealous. Not something I've experienced much, don't care for it.
Well, we did it. Eric and I talked. We screamed a bit. We got everything out in the open. It was pretty intense.
Look, Alex, I'm sorry, but can we talk about this another time? I'm going through some stuff right now, okay? There's a guy over there with his hands all over my cheesesteak.
Mr. Triviani, you got your start in theater. I have a question related to that.
Hit me.
Dramaturgically speaking, Deep Powder is clearly a rehashing of the Lear paradigm, combined with elements of Aristophanes and, of course, goes without saying, Sheridan. Now, will this source material inform your portrayal of the patriarch?
What?
People want to fire me all the time, and there's a real easy way to get out of it.
How?
By falsely accusing them of sexual harassment. Here's a little move I like to call the reverse. Huh? How dare you! I will see you in court.
I can't change your mind, then I'll take it like a man and...
Whoa, what are you doing?
I could ask the same question of you, sir. It's like I said in that holiday beer commercial that only aired in Germany. Das ist ein gut Christmas beer.
Joey, get out here. Beautiful women have been coming out of that apartment for like an hour.
An hour? Well, why didn't you get me?
I was stuck in the hot tub. I didn't want them to see my legs.
Well, hello there, gorgeous.
I don't have chicken legs.
Would you like to go and get some coffee?
Okay.
Oh, God, your legs. I gotta go.
Damn you, chicken legs!
You don't work on a soap opera without picking up a few things.
Well, I picked up a few things, too. If you don't give that back, I'm not gonna operate on your husband.
What?
I got nothing! All right. I haven't had anything to eat since I got in the car. Bring on the lasagna.
You got a problem, right? They wouldn't let me wait any longer. You weren't here, so I had to choose.
Oh, no. Who did you pick?
So now Mom's so upset she locked herself in the bathroom.
Should you be in the bathroom? I spent all this time preparing for the wrong role. You know, and they wouldn't even let me audition, and I would have been so great at it. If thrashing's a crime, yo, lock me up, because I don't want to live in a world where I can't thrash to the extreme. Alex. Isn't doing whatever it takes to achieve your dreams what Northwestern's all about?
No!
Then what is it about? I have to give a speech at the next alumni dinner.
Hi, my name's Thomas Wheeler. I'm here for my Northwestern alumni interview.
Whenever you're ready. Hi, Daddy.
How you doing? How are you doing? Is everything all right?
Why won't you let me go to Haley's sleepover party?
Because there's a blizzard coming. You could get snowed in.
You don't have to worry about me so much anymore. I mean, look at me. I'm a big girl now.
I can see that. I bet your friends think it's pretty lame that your old man wants to hold on to you so tight.
Now, who do I know that was 91? Lance Beckman. You know Lance?
Is he here?
No.
I was in his wedding.
Wait a minute. I'm here with your buddy, Lance. Here, you gotta see who this is. Huh?
Hey, it's me, Lance Beckman. Joey, I was in your wedding.
No, you weren't.
Okay, look, Steve, I have something I have to tell you. This man is not Lance Beckman. It's 2 in the morning. I'm hungry. What do you get me and why?
I'm gonna have to go with pizza, because you can eat it directly off your stomach without utensils while still lying in bed.
I gotta be honest with you, Glenn, you're blowing me away here.
A secret eyewitness, Joey Tribbiani. Joey Tribbiani.
I'm sorry, what did we say my cue was?
Just come out now.
Joey Tribbiani's phone. And what may I say this is regarding? I can't remember.
Hello? No. I don't know what time I'm supposed to be there. Well, I don't have my regular assistant, and the temp I got isn't working out. Let me call my assistant and I'll call you back. Okay. I can't believe it. Glenn turned his cell phone off.
I'll kill him for you.
Jim, maybe want to do something sometime?
Is this a test?
Yes.
What should I say?
Lauren, you are a beautiful, brilliant woman, but it wouldn't be right.
We work together.
That's a shame, Joey, because I want you so bad.
Yeah, what are you gonna do?
So that's basically the plot for the next episode. Any questions?
Yeah, I've been meaning to ask you. Since you didn't kill Bodhi and you didn't kill me, do you still need a plot twist?
Oh, I have a plot twist. There was somebody actually who behaved even worse than you did.
Hey, sweet mama. You want her to see me?
Yeah, Gunner, are you ready to shoot this scene?
I was born ready, baby. Hey, Detto. Guess who finally got a character? I'm a helicopter blade inspector. And I get to play drunk.
Joey, would you care to come watch this scene?
I think I'd like that, Lauren.